Next question is from Jordan Lacey. Should I be manipulating my macros every time I phase into a new workout regimen every 4 to 6 weeks?
I mean, maybe.
Yeah, I think you can.
I mean, you definitely can. I personally like to match my dietary changes with workout changes personally. It makes most sense to me from a psychological standpoint. Mm. I do this with clients. I do this with myself. Studies show pretty consistently, and I've experienced this time and time again with clients, that when somebody starts working out, they tend to naturally want to change their nutrition anyway. So you get this with clients all the time. Like you get a client, they're like, I want to do all these changes. And you say, okay, don't change your diet. Just let me train you for a little while so we can get you stronger, and then we'll tackle that later. And they end up naturally, I think because they know they're working out, they naturally start to change things a little bit. So pairing them together, in my experience, it's better. It seems to be effective. And so I do that with myself.
I think you learn this over time. You know, you kind of experiment and you see what your body does best with in terms of, you know, when you're in an intense workout, you know, I found I do need a bit of carbs. I need to up that a bit. I need that immediate energy access. It definitely helps me through performance-wise. And so I'm kind of like evaluating that versus if I'm more of in a restorative mode where I'm going to go a little bit higher in the fats and, you know, less in the carbs and up my protein. And so there's just ways to manipulate based on where you're at and what your current goals are. And you just kind of weave in and out of that. You definitely have to do the work of finding out first, like what foods work with you best and, you know, what your energy levels are and track all that.
But be careful not to overthink this, right? So, you know, I agree with both the guys. You absolutely can change it. I do like to manipulate it based off phases, similar to what Sal's saying. Justin brings up a great point. You start to figure out like, oh, a higher carb diet does better when I have like a higher intensity type of training. You know, all those things you learn over time. But also be careful of if you find something that is working really well with you. So diet is a little bit different, right? Even though I do believe that our body adapts to nutrition very similar as it adapts to anything else. So I'm sure there are some benefits to rotating and changing things out. But if you have found like a really good balance as far as this satiates me, it keeps me away from craving bad foods. I have energy when I work out. I sleep well. My gut feels healthy. If you've got that and it's all working for you, I wouldn't tell somebody just because we're moving into a new phase, like, hey, let's change it all up now. Let's increase your fats or let's, you know, decrease carbs for a little while if it's working really well for you. If all of those things are aligned and you're doing really well, why would you go do something completely different that may, you know, spike up the carbohydrate or spike up the cravings or, you know, start to interrupt sleep or start to lose some energy during your workout? So if the diet or whatever your plan or macro breakdown you're following is working really well for you, then I wouldn't mess too much with it, especially if you're seeing great results. Now, if you're not, you know, and you haven't hit that sweet spot or you see things like you notice, like, for example, bringing up the whole satiety thing. Sometimes I'll have a client like, oh, love the diet, Adam. It's going good. But man, around this time, I get hungry and I'm craving this and I'm doing that. So I might tell a client, okay, let's do this. Let's bump your fats a little bit or let's bump your protein. I'll give them a macronutrient that I know is more satiating to help curb some of the cravings that they're having. So instead of like reinventing the entire macro breakdown, you know, pay attention to those little subtle things. Or like to Justin's point, not having energy. Like let's say a client's training with me and they're like, man, Adam, I feel really good. You know, I'm sleeping well, all is well. But then when I go to our workout, sometimes I feel like halfway through, I just lose energy or I'm dragging to get there. Okay, well, I might bump their carbohydrates, you know, before they come to see me to kind of help combat that. So, you know, I would recommend more like that, like start to assess, you know, what you're noticing between sleep, energy, gut, all these things, and then manipulate macros to try and help those things out versus, oh, it's week six. I've been following this 60-20-20 breakdown and everything's going great, but I heard on Mind Pump I should change it up, you know, so you change, like, no, I wouldn't recommend that.